Welcome to the Everyday Mindfulness Show, where we educate and inspire people to live fuller lives through mindful practices. Let's get started with your host, New York Times contributor, leadership advisor, sought-after keynote speaker, the author of the Amazon hot new release, Everyday Mindfulness from Chaos to Calm in a Crazy World. She's smart, strong, sassy, and a trendsetter in the field of mindful leadership. Your host, Holly Duckworth.
Hello, and welcome to a fantastic episode of the Everyday Mindfulness Show. I'm going to start this week's show a little differently in honor of our guest today. And we have something in common, and that's a passion for bringing people into the present moment. So I just want to invite you. I'm going to ding my singing bell, and let's just take a collective breath together. Thank you so much. That is something I have wanted to do on the show for the last 25 episodes. And the radio doesn't, podcasts don't often give us a space for silence. But as we were preparing for the show, Nancy and I were talking about there is something really powerful about just breathing. So I want to welcome to the show our guest today, Nancy Addison. She is a health counselor, a nutritionist, a chef, a member of the National Speakers Association, delivering a message that you can be healthy in your body, in your mind, and in your spirit. Welcome to the show, Nancy.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
Well, you know, this show is all about mindfulness. And what makes mindfulness great is it's often steeped in ancient wisdom, but what makes it challenging is there's no one agreed upon definition for mindfulness. And so I like to start the show with your own individual definition, because that invites and informs all of us to be mindful in a way that works for us. So what's mindfulness mean to you?
For me, and I've really tried to practice this for the last, 7 or 8 years, but being present. Just keeping myself in the present moment, focusing on what I'm doing right now. And what I think happens so many times is people wake up thinking about what was going on yesterday and the day before, and they're probably mulling over past problems that, you know, they need to address or something. And it keeps them there. It keeps them in those past situations. And when you can shift that energy and be present and focus on what you're doing right now, I really do think miraculous things can happen.
So you're passionate. You've dedicated your life to this idea of health. And health, again, is one of those words that can mean a lot of things to a lot of people. Talk to us about health and how you work with that to strengthen us on the planet.
I believe true health is complete peace of mind. And so getting that peacefulness in your mind, body, and spirit is very important. So I work with psychosomatic body-mind communication. Whoops, there's my watchdog.
We love the watchdog.
We love our watchdogs. Here in Costa Rica, I'm kind of isolated, so it's always nice to know when someone's around. But what I've found is that a lot of us carry old emotional baggage with us in our subconscious, and different traumas that can occur to us, maybe the death of a loved one or an incident that was, you know, a car wreck or something that was traumatic. And what we do is we tend to, if we don't want to deal with that right at the present moment, because you have to live your life and do other things, we tend to shove that into our subconscious, and it kind of resides there in our cells. And so with the basic program of psychosomatic therapy, you release that and you go back into your subconscious, you meditate, and you see what surfaces, and you find the forgiveness, and you find the releasing of different things that you can't change now. Many times, some of the old traumas that we hold in our minds are things that we have no control over over anymore. And if we can release those, forgive ourselves for not being better at maybe dealing with that situation, and or forgiving other people for, you know, falling short of what we thought, you know, they should live up to. And if we can release all those things, it really is an amazing way to set ourselves free. And our minds are very, very powerful. And every time we have a thought, those electrons fire off in your brain and they make like little pathways. So if you're mulling over a problem or a trauma or something that is sad, then you're building those pathways and making them much stronger. If you can, let's just say for instance, focus on the positive, do something now, shift your energy, go for a walk, go sightseeing, bird watching, you know, paint some watercolors, do something that shifts your energy out of focusing on past traumas, you're actually going to build new brain pathways that are going to offset those old ones. And that can be a very powerful thing to do. And so thinking about new things, having new adventures, doing new experiences is really a very healthy thing to do. And I think in our fast-paced world today where people are trying just to keep up with the computer, we need to really just take a step back and take some deep breaths that take us out of that fight or flight mode, which prevents our DNA and our stem cells from working effectively. And just take some deep breaths and really focus on our heart and on the good things that are going on, and relax into that moment. And that can be actually extremely powerful as far as health is concerned, but also just for your well-being and for the people around you, because as you do this, your energy changes and it affects everyone around you.
As we were preparing for the show, we talked a lot about why, and that really resonates with me. You know, start with why. And to your point, we do live in a very busy, high-paced, fast-paced world. Why would somebody take the time out to be mindful?
I think many of the diseases today are caused from stress. And so what happens is people get caught up in work or dealing with problems or trying to take care of too many other people and not taking care of their selves. And they just get I see it very frequently, and I hear it from my clients, they just get exhausted. Well, when we are focusing on those types of things, we tend to be top lung breathers. And what that means is we are in a fight or flight mode. And when we are in that position, our body is not able to heal itself or rest. And this, I think, is a chronic problem today. And so taking that time out, doing the deep breathing, taking a ballet class or a yoga class or a walk where you can be with nature, get grounded, listen to your own inner voice, that can actually take you out of that fight or flight mode. And when you can do some deep breathing deep into your diaphragm, that's not just top lung breathing, and focus on something positive, the Heart Math Institute has found that that will actually regenerate your own stem cells. So it is, in my opinion, critical for our overall health and the people that we love, that we take care of, for us to be doing this. Otherwise, it becomes chronic. And we have the highest suicide rate in the world right now, and even with little children. And so I think getting away from the screens, getting away from the computers, getting into nature, getting grounded, which means you're really touching the earth and getting into that rhythm. When we are on cement or when we have shoes that divide us from the earth's frequency, it can actually affect us, and it can affect our mental ability as well. It'll make you feel kind of shaky, like you're not able to focus. And if that ever happens to you, if you can go outside and sit on the ground and just breathe deeply, it's amazing the healing effects that can have alone.
Now, Nancy, I know you've written 6 books on the topic, and one of the things that we have in common is this idea of working with CEOs and executives. And I'm sure you've had the same experience I have. You get the woo-woos, like this is so woo-woo. And yet sometimes that woo-woo can also come into a wow. Do you have a case study or an example of maybe an executive that you worked with that picked 1 or 2 or 3 of these techniques that you teach and how they transform themselves and then maybe even the culture of their organization by taking a little risk and leaning into this body, mind, spirit approach?
Yes. I mean, I have quite a few.
I thought you might.
Sometimes they're interventions by a loved one, like a sister or a wife or a best friend who sees what's happening to this person that they love and knows that they need to do something. Maybe they are so swollen and they almost look inflamed, or they've got cancer and they have kind of a gray pallor and really no life force left. And they just work all the time. And so I did one intervention about a year ago in Dallas, and the sister of this man called me, and I went in with her late at night on a Thursday night, and he's there working. And she just said, "We're intervening here." And we sat and talked for an hour, and I explained to him a few things that he could do that would help his health, because he was having a really bad hypertension. He was on a lot of medications and they didn't seem to be improving his health, and he was getting red. It almost looked like he was going to pop. I don't know if you've ever seen people like that, that have so much inflammation in their body that they just really look like they're going to explode. And it's really sad, and it's but it can be helped. And so just switching off his diet. So we made an appointment. He wanted to start right away. So we started the next morning. We went through his pantry. I explained to him why we were throwing out almost everything in his pantry. And he was right on board. And then we went to the grocery store and bought food. And he had had his personal assistant buying his meals for him. He had never cooked, never done anything for himself. He had terrible insomnia. And I just went on a 3-hour grocery store shopping trip with him. And we talked about, because when I go through their pantry, I know what they like to eat. I kind of get an idea of their preferences. And I don't believe in deprecation. I believe in, you know, like substituting, you know, shift it from the unhealthy version to a healthier version. And he's now, having never fixed his breakfast before, he's now making his own breakfast. He's sleeping at night. He sends me these wonderful emails about how it was like almost in a week he was getting blood tests back that were better than he'd gotten in years. And he travels a lot. So, you know, we talked about what he can do when he was in Thailand or in different places. And all of the suggestions I gave him apparently worked, and he's doing fantastically now. And I think he's definitely changed the way his whole company is working now, because working 24/7 and eating a lot of processed foods is just not. And they thought they were eating really healthy. I mean, they had a lot of salads but it was quality, and they just didn't have the quality there. But I don't know if we have time for one more person.
Well, let's take a quick break and then we'll come back to hear that story. We'll be right back to the Everyday Mindfulness Show. More with Nancy Addison in just a few moments.
The Everyday Mindfulness Show is brought to you by Leadership Solutions International. Are you hosting an upcoming conference or convention? Or looking for a speaker to provide inspiration and motivation? Would you like your audiences to know what you know as a listener of the Everyday Mindfulness Show? Check out Leadership Solutions International for more on mindful leadership keynote offerings, on-site mindfulness information centers, and trainings.
You're listening to the Everyday Mindfulness Show. Nancy, welcome back. So you left us hanging there. Tell us another story of transformation. Give us an example. I know there's many paths to the way people are coming at your work. You told us a story about somebody who had to do an actual intervention. Let's hear this story.
So very recently, and this one comes to mind because I hear this more and more often, and there's 1 in 20 children now that have constant seizures. And so I had a mother call me, and she was just really at the end of her emotional rope because her children were having so many seizures a day. She had 2 little boys. She still has them. They've stopped the seizures. But she said, you know, I worked with a nutritionist last year. I don't know if it really helped, but I found your book at the bookstore, and I just knew this was a sign, and I need you to come over, and I need you to just really completely redo my house and help me get everybody in my family on board. And she had a lot of health problems, ADD and hypertension and different things. And she was on a lot of medications. And so I went over there and we went through her pantry, and we literally threw out probably 5/6 of it. And it, you know, you look at it and it looks like high quality food. And yet when you read the ingredient labels and see, and you have to be able to kind of decipher some of these things, because they'll put things in as code that cover up the fact that it is MSG or it is high fructose corn syrup or it's something like that. And we I was like, are you sure you want to throw all this out? And she's like, yes, I need this desperately. We need to have a clean slate to start on. And so we went and did the grocery store shopping. I think we were there 3 or 4 hours. We totally restocked their pantry and their refrigerator. And she wanted me to counsel her husband and her mother, who her mother lives with them, because the children have been so ill and have had so many problems like autism and things since they were growing up. And so I started working with the mom who was drinking sodas, and I believe she's now cut them out finally. She, you know, cut them down initially, but she was one of the caregivers. So she would take the kids out to get fast food or what she thought was healthy fast food. And she would be making special foods for them at home, but they were things she grew up with that were white and processed and didn't have nutrient density in them and had certain ingredients in them that were, I think, causing a lot of these problems. And then for her husband's birthday, he actually asked to have me give him a cooking lesson with her. And we had an absolute marvelous afternoon cooking and fixing things, because he loves to grill and do things like that. And they really needed to shift their diet to be more plant-based and healthier, with more vegetables and antioxidants and fiber. And within the first week, the seizures really cut down. And I helped him buy certain supplements that most people, they wonder about supplements, but most supplements are actually a waste of money because they're synthetic or artificial and they really don't help you. And so finding the right kind of supplements is important, because so many people are mineral and nutrient deficient because the food today just is not nutrient and mineral dense. We hear about superfoods, and superfoods are foods that are grown in an intact rainforest, usually with very rich soil. And so the food has all the nutrition in it. But the farming practices, especially in the U.S. today, are so poor, and they have so many chemical fertilizers and pesticides put on them that it destroys the very valuable nutrients in the soil. But it also adds the toxic carcinogenic glyphosate to your food, which can affect your health in other ways, which are very dangerous. So teaching them about quality, getting everybody on board so everybody understands why they're eating this way. Now when the mom takes the kids to the pantry to get a snack, she's like, okay, contest, who can pick the healthiest snack today? And, you know, just explaining to them, this is what is helping you not have seizures anymore. This is, you know, helping you be able to go to school now and play with your friends. So, you know, it's amazing how dramatic some of these turnarounds can be when people start really getting the right quality of food in their diet. And so in my books, I have half recipes because I really believe a lot of people aren't preparing their foods properly. And I think that's also a critical part of that.
Well, that was one of the things I wanted to talk about is I you showed me some of your books. And for those who aren't seeing the video, but you're just getting the audio, I mean, these books are meaty encyclopedias that really address, you know, the why, the how, the what on both the big picture level, but also the individual level. And I loved it when you said there was recipes. I have a new chef in my life, so we're always trying something new with food. A lot of the things you talk about, like 4 hours grocery shopping or, these big meals or these big things, but your book gives us little entry points, nuggets that we can try. The most recent book, as I understand it, is How to Be a Healthy Vegetarian. Is that right?
Well, that's in a second edition.
Second edition, okay.
So diabetes in your diet, raising healthy children, those are all, I think my newest one really is tube feeding. So many people have throat cancer today, and I'm a tube feeding expert. I'm also a certified licensed wildlife rehabilitator, and I was a tube feeding expert, mostly specializing in baby possums. And when I started working with people who had throat cancer and needed to be tube fed, I found that what they are recommending is fructose corn syrup supplements that, in my opinion, are literally the worst thing you can give someone who has health challenges. And so, like for Larry Hagman, the actor who played JR in Dallas, he was one of my clients. And Linda Gray and I kind of did an intervention with him. He had the gray pallor in his face, and he had cancer and diabetes. And he was starting to get ready to shoot a new show for the show Dallas. And so he hired me as his nutritionist and chef. And I switched his diet. And it was amazing. Within the first week and a half of him actually sticking to the diet and not cheating on it, his health just turned around like that. His color came back in his face. He had more energy. The people on the show, the producer was like, man, we should have written him into more of the scenes. And he was just doing great. He came in one day and he said, Nancy, and it was only about a week and a half after he really started sticking to the diet, or the eating plan, I like to say. But he said, Nancy, I've had the best blood test I've ever had in 16 years. And he was just elated. And of course that inspired him to do better, but he did have throat cancer. And at one point he had to do tube feeding. And he asked me about the cans of stuff they actually made him buy at the hospital. And I just looked at it and I thought, this is probably the last thing I would want you to take. It's full of chemicals and high fructose corn syrup. And they were only focused on calories. And it really comes down to quality. And high fructose corn syrup, especially for a diabetic, can be really awful because it can interfere with your pancreas and its insulin and also the leptin hormone. And diabetes is really a dysfunction of your cells not communicating, your hormones not communicating, specifically the insulin and the leptin hormone. So I developed a tube feeding recipe for him that was just fantastic. And he really thrived on it. And so anyway, I had so many people asking me about my tube feeding recipes that I created a little recipe book for it. And so that was my latest book. But all my books are now out on audio just as of about 2 weeks ago. So I'm very excited about that as well.
Wow, that's a huge accomplishment and reaches a whole new audience of listeners. So lots of ways people can work with you. I was really excited to learn about counseling families. And certainly you have a lot of other offerings. Tell us a little bit about how people can work with you and how they can find you.
Thank you. Well, my website is Organic Healthy Life, L-I-F-E. And you can contact me through that. And I also have a free newsletter that you can sign up for. And I have a YouTube channel and you can watch some of my recipes. But I love working with groups. Frequently, I'll get hired by a whole group of people, a junior league group, or I just got hired by the New York City Horticulture Society to teach some classes next fall. And I love working with the big groups because you can really make an impact that way, because everybody's sharing that information and they're understanding it, and they can, you know, go back and say, hey, what did Nancy say about this? Or, hey, you want to come over and cook this recipe with me? And especially with a family, with someone with a health challenge, like a stage 4 cancer or a rare blood disease or something like that, you know, most of the people at home are eating the way they were eating when they got sick. So it's really great to get everybody on board, and everybody understands why this person is starting to eat differently. And once people understand it, they really do really support that person. And then they start switching and they start feeling better. And before you know it, it expands to the whole family and the extended family and the neighbors as well. And it's just a great feeling. And most of my clients come from referrals or from people seeing me speak and then saying, well, you've got to speak at my group. And so Natural Grocers just hired me to speak at some of their store openings next fall and in the summer.
And well, that is awesome. I'm so excited. But you've actually done something really cool for our listeners that not a lot of guests have done. And I want to give you a chance to tell us about the way we can interact with you through your Take Control of Your Health program.
Right. I've never done a webinar before, and this is live on Zoom where I can do question and answers at the end. And being in Costa Rica, I just got so excited about sharing some of this information with others. And I met a lady here who's an expert on these. And so she's like, Nancy, you really need to share this. Everybody's struggling with stress and weight and hormone problems, and their libidos are low, and depression. Depression's huge. And she said, it would be really great if you would do a seminar with them. And so I'm offering that, and it's affordable, I think, for everybody. So it's under $100, and it's 3 live workshops with me with questions and answers and a downloaded manual. And if you sign up really soon by Monday, then you get to get the bonus pack, which means you get to be in a live question answer video with me here in my kitchen in Costa Rica.
Awesome. Well, we're going to include that in the show notes because that's a very specific link for our people. But if people want to get general information about your books, your coaching, what's the best website to track you down at?
Probably mine, organichealthylife.com.
Organichealthylife.com. Well, thank you for saying yes to this passion, for helping us to live healthier lives in body, mind, and spirit, and to remember to just breathe in and breathe out.
Take care of yourself.
Yes. Self-care is not selfish. I like to remind people of that. And you are helping us eat healthy and be more healthy no matter where we live. So thank you so much. We hope you'll come back and join us again. Remember, mindful matters, and so do you.
Thank you for joining us for today's show. For more mindfulness every day, visit everydaymindfulnessshow.com and download the 3-day challenge and experience the ABCs of mindfulness. Mm-hmm.